Hello, everybody. You guys have to let me know, like, if this is smooth. I'm clearly at a motel. This is a pretty ghetto setup, so I apologize. And obviously there's gonna be some weird noises going on. But yeah, we're gonna get through this. And hello, Ivermectin. Hi, Mr. Crow, Nemesis, Eric G. Good day, sir. Hi, Tom Cooper. Hi, Meatball. Hi, MDH1970. Hi, McClary's. Let me see. And hello, Gary Bellwood. Let me see who else I missed. And sounds good. Thank you. Oh, Tiger Lily. I appreciate it. Hi, Bill Cosby, ASMR. Let me see. Hi, Jessica Williams and Desert Rain and Gina G. Okay, I think I am caught up. Hear me, beautiful. Hi, Jay Snyder. All right, so very good. And thank you, Knight 1118. Thank you. All right, guys. So, this is going to be a wetting our beak about, Mr. Massimo Intravigne. Yeah. Cause a lot of people don't know who he is. A lot of people haven't heard of him. So we're just going to give a little quick breakdown by some fascinating things that have gone down on Twitter as of late. And we're going to see some pretty controversial takes from Massimo. Hello, Ivana, and hello, Della Purchase. Because, of course, you know, Lucien is involved. So is William Sims Bainbridge. But I'm trying to show you guys, and I'm not telling people what to think, but I'm trying to show you guys that, like, there's another agenda at play. And it's not a good one, especially with the stuff that's been going on in Utah and Lucien's smart-ass comments about that. And then I'll just have some other random stuff to talk to you guys about before I go, but I'm just going to pick a random intro and we'll get going.
What is the process?
Must we drag all that up again?
Is it old to the death? Better hold your breath. In the cell, I prevail. Freddy sent from hell. Ring the bell when you're finished. I'm a grown man and winning. Sacrificing to the demons. No, I love it when you screaming. Commit to your thoughts. Do it now what you lost in the darkness. You will never wake up so conscious, anxious. Why are you so scared of feeling pain, bitch? Devil in your soul. Cut it now and then you'll go. Walk on the dark path. Kill and you feel that. Never in your life you gotta rush from the kickback. Matt Black, Glock 10, knock on the neck, man. Hear the whispering, devil taking over them. Listen to my words of Freddy, tell it do the devil's work. Listen to my words of Freddy, tell it do the devil's work. All red, homie, got the blood up in your hair. Sign your soul to the devil, now you asking is it fair? Listen to my words of Freddy, tell it do the devil's work. Listen to my words of Freddy, tell it do the devil's work. All red, homie, got the blood up in your hair. Sign your soul to the devil, now you asking is it fair?
Listen to my words of Freddy, tell it do the devil's work. Listen to my words of Freddy, tell it do the devil's work. Listen to my words of Freddy, tell it do the devil's work. Listen to my words of Freddy, tell it do the devil's work. Listen to my words of Freddy, tell it do the devil's work.
Okay, my internet is super laggy, guys. So hopefully if I get laggy, you guys have to tell me because, like, I will end the stream. So please let me know. Hi, hello. What is the process? Yeah, I think there's still some debate on, like, if it's just the process being called that or if it is, like, a local thing, you know, depending on where you come from. So what I'm going to do first is I've made just a kind of basic PowerPoint just to show you guys some pictures, show you what this fella's into, because the origins of this, I told Virginia this story with you guys. So Virginia is actually the one that introduced me to Massimo Intravigno, but when she did, and I said, well, who is he? Because he tried to have her blog taken down. Many people know the website Cessner. So he is the founder and operator of that website. But when she described him to me, it was two words that I had never heard together before. And it was kind of an ontological shock. He's a Catholic extremist. That's as horrifying as it sounds, right? I never thought that I would hear those two words together because, like, I don't know. Some people could say that, you know, like really Orthodox OG Catholics are pretty extreme, right? There's obviously extremists in every religion, but he's literally a Catholic extremist. That was the first time that I had heard it. But we are going to look at a few fun pictures. I'm going to show you guys a couple of books that he has written. I'm also going to show you what he had to say about Mr. Greaves himself. And then we're going to see some of his, again, more controversial takes on certain topics, because this dude is a major sus lord. And yes, I did pick unflattering photos. Not that I think any of his photos are flattering. However, so this is a young Massimo. I found a photo of him with hair, so that was kind of exciting, I guess, because I thought maybe he never had hair. Hair always had the cut, and there he is. Sociologo Direttore Cessner. I don't know if I'm saying that right. Very angry man. Now, this is a video that I started watching. It's only on Facebook, but this sounds like nightmare fuel. Post-apocalyptic life era conference in 2020 at the European Academy of Sciences of Ukraine. So that's good. People should feel comfortable that he's talking about post-apocalyptic life era in Ukraine. Yeah. Now, here he is dressed as a vampire at the vampire convention in Transylvania. Yeah. So isn't that just lovely? Now, let me see. I don't think I have the links in this comment, because some of these I'm going to just drop in the chat afterwards. So obviously, what does Wikipedia have to say? Look at him. He just looks like he's thinking, right? He's just a sociologist of religion. Look at that hand, head on the hand, huh? Yeah. So he was born in Rome 1955 as an Italian Roman Catholic who studies the sociology of religion, and he is an intellectual property attorney. The attorney part is where things obviously come into play and benefit the groups that he covers in particular. So right there, it says he is a founder and the managing director of the Center for Studies of New Religions, or Cessner, a Turin-based organization, which has been described as the highest profile lobbying and information group for controversial religions. Lobbying, 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 lobbying. Now, right here, it says Intervigne at the bottom is a proponent of the theory of religious economy developed by Rodney Stark. Now, there we go. Oh, look, a theory of religion. Rodney Stark and William Sims Bainbridge. A future of religion. Rodney Stark and William Sims Bainbridge. Religion, deviance, and social control. Rodney Stark and William Sims Bainbridge. Isn't that lovely? Is my mic breaking up? Is the sound not working, guys? Let me know. Because like I said, I'm not going to do a stream if the sound is terrible. But yes, Opus Dei. Yeah, it's all real bad news. Because what it sounds like to me, in my personal opinion, is that Massimo is a proponent of not just Rodney Stark, but also William Sims Bainbridge. You know what I mean? It's working just slightly choppy. Okay. If it's okay, just let me know. I'm a little insecure about that. I had to pay $20 for the Wi-Fi here for one day. That's all I could afford. I was like, and it's not even that good. And as a reminder, William Sims Bainbridge is a graduate of Harvard. And Doug Lucien, got into Harvard with the help of a process church member who graduated from Harvard. So let's not forget, okay? Because this is very important. And as a reminder, because this is something I'm not going to let go of, do you believe it is not suspicious in any way whatsoever that you left out the process's children in prison outreach ministries, as did Josh Zeman, and propaganda pieces you were involved in about the process? Yes or no? No. No. That's all we need to know. Thanks, Doug. Dick. Anyways, so two books. I am not reading from the Sacred Eroticism. There's a lot of weird talk about semen and the ingestion of urine. Really, not reading that, but I would at least like there. And then he obviously wrote Satanism. We will be looking into that a little bit. And this is the tweet that really set things, because I didn't know that Messina had visited the Satanic Temple. And so I find this photo of Lucien Doug right there. And you notice how old boy is standing right in front of that, and it almost looks like wings or his wings, horns. I don't really know if that was purposeful or not. But from this book right here, this is The Darkest Side of Politics to State Terrorism, Weapons of Mass Destruction, Religious Extremism, and Organized Crime. So I pointed out, thought it was interesting that they were together, and that Massimo Intervigne, founder of the Centro Studi Sulle, I'm going to butcher this, Nuove Religioni Sessner, right? But he is a leading member of Alleanza Cattolica, aka the Catholic Alliance, the Italian counterpart of TFP, the extremist ultra-traditionalist Catholic group established in South America. I'm not going to get into all of this today, guys. I'm just laying the groundwork here. He is a right-wing Catholic extremist. I did ask if him and Lucien had matching vampire costumes, because I really can't get over that photo. I'm sorry. So right here is where Doug finally shut up. For anybody that's been on Twitter, where Doug just engages in a bunch of conjecture and complete nonsense. And I did block out the follower of mine and whom I follow, and just in case, I don't know if they want to be put out here like that. If they do leave a comment, then I will totally like credit them, because they made a great point, and I am going to share the links to these papers with you guys. But they replied, because this was Doug's response. He is a scholar of new religious movements who wrote a book called The Social History of Satanism, and you're wondering why he came to the temple? Maybe you're easily see, because Lucien Doug, he thinks that he's smarter than everybody else, and he's not. However, this person said, why did your buddy Massimo write these articles defending Father Marcel Maciel, the most notorious pedophile in the Catholic Church? Why did he attack a study set up by the Dutch government in the wake of abuse cover-ups by Jehovah's Witnesses, calling it Russian and Chinese disinformation? He's just a scholar. Fuck off. Massimo wants you hoodwinked by Russian and Chinese spies into taking abuse testimony seriously. In a few cases, sickos like him leap in to defend strong against the weak. And he made a point. Post where they're giving this expert opinion in regards to sexual abuse and willingness to report within the community of Jehovah's Witnesses. Now, look who else is here. Because the ex-Scientology cult movement, these people who talk about, you know, like J. Gordon Melton. Yeah, look who's chiming in here. He's okay. You guys getting it? He's getting it that these people all work together. But right here, look at this. Creating false accounts on social networks, the Chinese and Russian government. Imagine that. That's pretty convenient, isn't it? And again, right here, just breaking it down more, trying to legitimize it. It's a joke. It's a joke. VPN and their IP address, blah, 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 blah. And they even use the word trolls. Imagine that. I mean, it's like, come on, man. I mean, these people are sick. In my opinion, I mean, I think that he's sick. I think that he's disgusting. And, you know, it's not that people can't believe what they want to believe. It's them presenting to the public advocates of religious freedom and advocates of free speech and protection of the First Amendment. There's a different agenda at play. And I'm going to show you guys that someone informed Dana her mic is shutting on and off at times. I'm sorry, guys. If it gets really bad, let me know, because I'm just going to like end the stream because I feel very insecure about it. I'm sorry. It's this crappy hotel Wi-Fi. I'm sorry, guys. All right. Well, let me try to get through the rest of this quickly, and hopefully that doesn't make it worse. Ugh. Whatever. Okay, then I'm just going to pull up like the most important thing first, because it is like the most relevant, it's most current. That way you guys can see it. So this I shared today in particular, and then Doug pulled out his whole, you use Netflix for your research. You're an idiot, blah, 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 blah. And I'm like, you're a charlatan. You're a charlatan. You're a scam artist. These people are con. Now, right here is Bitter Winter. He is the chief editor of this publication. Okay. Now, little Doug Lucien was throwing a hissy fit about laws that are being proposed and passed in Utah in regards to ritual abuse, because these people want you to believe it does not exist, and they also want you to believe that for some reason only satanic religions don't engage in child abuse. That's what they want you to believe. Somehow every other one does, except for, okay, but right here, April 15th, 2023, Massimo Intravigne, Arizona Supreme Court protects secret of confession in the LDS case. Although a man had boasted of his sexual abuse of his daughter on social media, what he told to his Mormon church leaders in a confessional context remains protected. I am not going to sit here and read all of this. However, we're going to get to the good stuff. And yes, I will drop in these links. But right here, this is what you need to know. Sexual abuse of children is a horrible crime. It is understandable that some believe that even the principle of the secret confession should suffer an exception in these horrific cases. However, for many religions, the secret of the confession rests on a divine mandate and is at the core of their faith. Once a breach is opened on its protection in cases of child sexual abuse, other breaches will follow. What if penitents confess that they are preparing a terrorist attack or identify themselves as serial killers? In the end, the secret of the confession will simply disappear. So that man right there says that confession, your quote unquote religious freedom, is more important than protecting children. That is what he said. These are his words. I don't think that anybody can really look me in the face and say that they're a serious person and say that that guy has anybody's interest at heart besides himself. Yeah? I don't know, guys. This whole thing makes me quite angry, but I mean, this is literally just going to be like a very short primer to this man, because I'm going to ask everybody a question before I pull up the social history of Satanism. And you don't have to answer. However, in what reality is the umbrella of Satanism? So the Church of Satan, the Satanic Temple, if there's a Temple of Satan, the Temple of Set, whatever other ones, the Process, Best Friends Animal Society, why is it the ones that involve Satan that this doesn't exist? Is anybody getting what I'm getting at? Seriously, like, that doesn't make sense. It shouldn't make sense. It should be very clear there is something different at play. Because Massimo found saying that, you know, you can confess to abusing your own child, but as long as it's done inside of a church, the child doesn't matter. So how does Doug Messner, Doug Masico, Lucien Greaves, why does he expect the public to buy his persecuted Satanist angle, and we're all supposed to believe that somehow that elevated theological study, the reconciliation of opposites, that they happen to not engage in that, right? Because they're immune to human nature and human depravity. Okay. Yep. Excuse my language, get fucked. So let me go ahead and pull up this book, The Social History of Satanism. Not going to read the whole thing, but right here. So Satan the Activist, the Satanic Temple. So apparently the Satanic Temple started as a Facebook page in 2013 with the purpose of recruiting amateur actors for a documentary on a new form of Satanism. The project was the brainchild of Douglas Messner, aka Doug Masico, aka Lucien Greaves, although he would later claim that the Satanic Temple was actually conceived of independent from me by a friend and one of his colleagues. Why is he passing the buck? It's a little bit weird. But Messner's involvement in Satanism was connected with two episodes discussed earlier in this book, LaVey's use of Ragnar Redbeard's Might is Right for his Satanic Bible, and the promotion by some therapist of alleged survivors of satanic ritual abuse. Doug's little degree in false memory syndrome comes in handy. You get it? Does that make sense? Does that make sense for everybody? So, Messner, a young artist and illustrator, was enthusiastic about the book. He contacted Shane Bugby and eventually illustrated a new limited leather-bound edition of Might is Right, published by the same Bugby in 2003. And right here is Mr. Shane Bugby and Dig discussing interviewing inner circle members of the notorious Process Church of the Final Judgment, which was said by some to be the world's most dangerous satanic cult. Through you, I met a variety of self-proclaimed Satanists of the LaVeyan school and others. Messner studied neuroscience at Harvard. Oh, did he? Why don't you just say what he studied? He studied false memory syndrome. This came out of Harvard. William Sims Bainbridge and Elizabeth Loftus. Coincidence? I don't think so. However, he became familiar with 20th century literature on satanic ritual abuse and survivors. He was deeply disturbed when he discovered that a small group of therapists was still spreading this literature and the narrative of satanic ritual abuse, despite the fact that it had been largely debunked by academic critics in the 90s. Really? Did they, Massimo? Did they, Doug? Again, I will ask, why is that one religion? Why is it just that one? That's the question that I have now. That's where I'm at with the satanic And I get that they're super litigation happy. They sue about everything. Doug sued Twitter. That's what a joke he is. But I don't care. I would like someone to make a logical argument to me that the umbrella of Satanism, and it is an umbrella, why are they the only group? And why are they always crying persecution? They act like every jail. They act like there were no medical records. They act like split personality, DID, whatever you want to call it, dissociative identity disorder, like that's not real. But he's supposed to be an expert in neuroscience, right? So that doesn't really make sense to me. Now, I am going to show you guys, and no, we're not going to read the whole thing, but for those Bishop Pace and the Pace memo, I am going to show you guys because wouldn't you know it? Wouldn't you know it? In 1994, the Mormon History Association invited Mr. Massimo Intervigne to come give a speech. And what was that speech for? To discredit the victim was describing in that memo. The situation that he described in that memo that is going on right now with the Leavitts. The SRA case in Utah right now. The case that is very likely a catalyst for them trying to pass the... And one of the ministers of the Satanic Temple made the most asinine comment, and of course he didn't reply. But he said, oh, they're going after mock weddings. I could see the police rolling up on kids playing in the playground, playing house, and pretending to get married. And I said, you are making a really stupid argument. And you sound silly, especially. I said, A, the Satanic Temple's statement, their belief, what they present to the public, is that ritual abuse isn't real. So why are you guys worried? It's question number one. Question number two. Ritual abuse is generally done under the supervision of adults in private as a, wait for it, a ritual. So equating that with a stupid, stupid comparison of kids playing house on the playground, this is how Satanists are trying to get laws passed in their favor. And this is why people need to pay attention to the things that come out of these people's mouths. Because obviously, like, Lucian is really terrible at public debate, but that's because he's a little girl and he can't handle it and he just wants to cry Netflix about everything. However, let's go ahead and see what Massimo had to say. So, right here, this is a paper read by Massimo Intervigne at the annual conference of the Mormon History Association, MHA, Park City, Utah, May 21st, 1994. A rumor of devils. Allegations of satanic child abuse and Mormonism, 1985 to 1994. Now, whoops, hold on. To read through all of this. However, he is discussing the Bishop Pace memo right here because that was a confidential report for an internal study of the church. And people need to just read that memo for themselves and not listen to what other people say about it. It's freaking ridiculous. But I mean, look at how long this is.
Go through the entire history, and I'm going to use Leo Taxil as an argument. Blah, 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 blah. Oh, anti-cult and counter-cult. Ooh.
Who else was in the anti-cult movement? Jolly West. Jolly West. Margaret Singer. Richard Offshee. We see a lot of the same names, same faces, seemingly unrelated, right? However, this is what's important to me. A bitter debate exists between national lobbies who argue respectively that children always tell the truth, believe the children, and that their memories are often false. False Memory Syndrome Foundation. However, while not even a single court conviction has been on the survivors' stories, at least a handful of cases exist in which abusers who appear to have used satanic symbols and paraphernalia have been convicted based on reports by children. There was no evidence that these abusers belonged to international organized satanic cults, and no reports of human sacrifice have been confirmed. Some therapists do not believe in the stories of the survivors, but they do believe that some of the stories of satanic abuse told by children are true. And then down here, he's discussing, adolescents that listen to rock music and maybe take drugs, you know, that you can't really get those things mixed up. That's dangerous, right? And this is where the people that simp for like the West Memphis 3 come in. Yeah, that's where that comes in. Because there's people that still think that the West Memphis 3 is innocent and their argument documentary. And I've already told you guys, I had my learning moment with that. I accept it. You know, I wasn't out like lobbying for them, obviously. But, you know, I told you guys, like, I was happy when they got released. And then once I figured out that I was lied to, because this is these people's jobs, is propaganda. You know, there are murderers out on the street. These are people that have a lot of power. They have a lot of lobbying power. And for now, it would seem that Mr. Bainbridge is really key in all of this, right? He seems to be sort of like the tie that binds right now. Him and Stark. Because like I said, today is literally just us like wetting the beak. Because Virginia has done a ton of research on Massimo, because like I said, he tried to have her blog taken down. Because they don't like when you start talking about the cults being intelligence fronts, right? They don't like that. Obviously, Massimo didn't win. However, I told you guys I'm not delicate anymore moving forward. Doesn't mean I'm going to come on here and like be super crass. Sometimes I may slip out an F-bomb or something and I apologize. But I'm done being politically correct as far as like Lucian and the Satanic Temple, the Church of Satan, all of it. I'm done. And it has nothing to do with my theological beliefs, looking at these things and reading these people's words themselves. Okay? That doesn't make me a religious extremist. That doesn't mean that I'm here with ulterior motives. What do I have to gain? Absolutely nothing. But, you know, eventually we're going to come back. We're going to look at some of the OSS studies that Virginia, where they're literally talking about the creation of cults so that they can study them. Yeah. And how, you know, there's a very good argument that Mr. Introvigne is literally just a Vatican intelligence asset. He's a spook for the Catholic Church. And obviously, that relates into the shown you guys, Reverend Arthur Gibson. I'm not even going to show the stupid stuff that he wrote in The Social History of Satanism because it's dumb. I'll upload it to my my internet archive, my Wayback Machine. It's stupid. Marianne was an auditor, but they weren't raking Scientologists, and they were declared, and they take a Jungian and Adler approach, and it was more about psychology than occultism. Okay. whatever you say. I'm just letting everybody know, not trying to hurt anybody's feelings. I've had someone say, like, you're going to isolate the Satanists. Don't care. Don't care. Don't care anymore. Don't care anymore. Want to believe, but when these people are out here trying to pass laws and being dishonest with the public and also re-traumatizing victims by lying, is re-traumatizing to victims. The fact that Utah is trying to pass that law about ritual abuse is a huge deal. And here comes Lucien, Doug, and his assholes crying satanic panic. Right? It's a joke. And you guys already know that that is a very sore spot with me. Now, I want to show you guys this fascinating magazine that Virginia found. And we're not a thing, but look at how old this is, man. I love this stuff. It was such a good find for her. So, Anti-Scene and The Cult Wars Part 2. I don't know what the swing and udders are. The gizmos, the Spitfires, the usual cast of miscreants. So here they are discussing the cult wars. Yeah. And the debates about so-called new religious movements. These people are taking a bit of a different approach. However, they're not wrong. They're not wrong. Now, obviously, this is long. I am going to also put this into my archive because I have a feeling the longer that I stay on this stream, the more laggy and crappy the sound is going to get. However, let me zoom in right here. Whoop. There we go. All right. Read only his scholarly publications, Massimo's, devoted to NRMs or new religious movements. One could easily get the impression that Intravigne is an extreme civil libertarian, a remarkably tolerant liberal, and perhaps even a countercultural bohemian or decadent libertine. See, for example, his Satanism, Scares, and Vampirism, which he presented to the 1997 World Dracula Congress in LA. However, nothing could be further from the truth. Who, then, is Intravigne? And what accounts for his ongoing campaign against cult critics of strength? And right here, it details that he was an author for the Rightist Weekly to Borghese, the mouthpiece of the conservative double-breasted suit faction within the neo-fascist electoral party, the Movimento Sociale Italiano, or the Italian Social Movement. So, there he is. Okay, that's it. I'm keeping it very simple for now. Okay, like I said, I think that the words Catholic extremists put together are pretty intense. So, and honestly, like I said, I didn't really know how the Wi-Fi was going to go in here, guys. And I am very self-conscious about that kind of stuff. So I don't want to run this too long. I just wanted to give you guys a little bit of background, some pictures, because you know I love pictures and I think that they're fun. I will, when I'm done, upload these to the Internet Archive. I have added my Wayback Machine link into my link tree. And Massimo is going to be somebody that we're going to come back to again and again and again and again. And again. And again. Because I told you guys, I don't buy like the whole LaRouche, like British plot to like take over the United States and destroy the United States. I think it's a battle between like, you know, the Vatican and them. Right? Maybe some other people. But, you know, Massimo's going to keep coming into play. Yeah. So we'll be revisiting him more. Because I would like to show a lot of Virginia's work. Because she's done some really amazing work. And I think that it speaks to the quality of her research that that guy took the time to try and get her blog taken down. And he lost. Right? Because these people are crybabies. Who knew that a right-wing Catholic extremist who likes to dress up like a vampire would be such a delicate crybaby, just like Lucien Greaves, Doug Messner, Doug Masico. Now, the other thing that I wanted to let you guys know is I'm almost done. I don't have a time and I don't want to lie to you guys. So I'm not going to give a specific time right now. I am going to put in the community section though that the video of Doug and Parker, it's almost done. I am going to set it up for a premiere. Okay, I've never done that before. So like when I upload my schizo clips, it gives me a chance. It's like, do you want to do this as a premiere? And it's like, you'll have a live chat. And I'm like, well, it's a schizo clip. It's going to be 2 minutes. People aren't even going to be there. But this is a longer video. And so I am going to set it up as a premiere. That way you guys can see it. It's not super duper. But that way, if people want to be there in the live chat, and I'll be in the live chat, obviously, then people can engage and kind of react in real time. So it's really important to me. Once I get the link up, I will share it on Instagram and Twitter and in my community section. And this is the only time that I will ask you guys if you guys would share the link. Okay. Because this is important to me. You know, I don't ask you guys to do anything like that. And you don't have to. I'm not going to be upset. I'm not keeping tabs on everybody. Okay. But I just, you know, if you guys wouldn't mind sharing this, it's important. It's important and it's fun. And I think that you guys are really going to enjoy it. And I'm really looking forward to premiering it. And then after that, after I get that up, because I'm not going to be here for much longer, and hopefully I will be to somewhere where I have better Wi-Fi, I'm going to let you guys see something. I'm not trying to be evasive, but I do have to be a little bit strategical because someone has threatened me. Okay. Like legitimately threatened me. I'm not scared, but you guys know how I roll, right? But I want to get this video up first because I think the video is important. I don't want to isolate people because of that. I want this to stand on its own. Really cool tribute, you know, and I'm just grateful that Parker's allowing me to help because this has nothing to do with me. And that needs to be made very clear. That's why I'm not showing it on this stream. This has nothing to do with me. This is me giving Parker a platform. That's all. But there are going to be quite a few people who have to eat crow. You're going to have to eat your fucking crow breakfast. Feel bad. So we'll leave it at that for now. I'm going to go ahead and run the exit. And I'm sorry if this was super laggy and crappy. Again, paid for Wi-Fi that you guys said didn't really work that well. So not you, Mr. Crow. Not going to eat you. Well, I mean, I don't know which way you swing. I don't want to talk about it. That's your personal business, Mr. Crow. I hurt you. I'm going to run the exit and I don't know when I'm going to be like back to Wi-Fi. I was hoping this Wi-Fi would be decent. It cost $20. Obviously not. But I'll let you guys know. But I am going to get that video uploaded and I will give you guys a heads up. And thank you guys for joining in. Sorry if this was crappy. Bye.